This coming from someone who's actually going to SummerSlam. I am not excited one bit for SummerSlam. You know why? Because there is one thing, a total of one thing to be excited about in the entire SummerSlam show. You know what that is? That's CM Punk versus John Cena, and now Triple H is added as a special referee. Gee, I wonder if Triple H is going to screw someone during that match. Nah, they wouldn't do something like that. But do you know how much time was spent on the show dedicated to promoting the CM Punk, John Cena, and Triple H thing? Do you know how much time was dedicated to those guys? A total of 51 minutes and some change. And that's not even counting how much the freaking announcers were shoving it down our throats during every match that had nothing to do with them. And this is the only thing going on in WWE right now. And this show kind of proved that this is the only thing we should care about and everything else. No, screw that. That's not even important. And this show proved it. Because guess what else we got tonight? We got three matches that were supposed to be safe for SummerSlam and whatnot. Rey Mysterio versus The Miz. What happened in that match? The Miz attacked Rey Mysterio before the match even got started. And is that hype for the match at SummerSlam? Are they going to announce it at SummerSlam? I don't know. Didn't we see this match like a million times this month already? And then another one, Alex Riley versus Dolph Ziggler. Vicky Guerrero gets Dolph Ziggler disqualified, and I guess that's some kind of hype, but doesn't get me all that excited. And then another match, R-Truth beats John Morrison clean in the middle of the ring. Clean in the middle of the ring, no controversy whatsoever. So are they going to have a match at SummerSlam? No, they're not going to have a match at SummerSlam because there's no point to have a match at SummerSlam because we already had a clean finish on Raw, and basically, John Morrison would be an idiot to want a rematch since that was as clean as it could have been. And then there was that Miz versus Kofi Kingston match that shouldn't have even been on the card, that they should have just ended it after the Miz beat up Rey Mysterio. There was no need to have that match. And then we have Best Phoenix and Mickie James in a match, which I'm sure people are going to say, oh, best match, best Divas match of the entire year, just because Best Phoenix is in it and Best Phoenix is getting a push. This match really wasn't all that great. I mean, it was okay, Best Phoenix tossing Mickie James around and Mickie James botching all her kicks, and that's pretty much all this was. It pretty much just got the same amount of time every Diva match gets, 3 minutes, and then afterwards Best Phoenix gets on the mic and cuts a horrible promo sounding like Dolph Ziggler, and then Kelly attacks her from behind, and that's supposed to be their hype. Yes, this is a real Divas rivalry. This is real Divas rivalry. The Divas are alive because Best Phoenix and Natalya, they're alive, right? Right? I don't get it. Just hoping that this little thing that Best Phoenix is doing is turning into some Diva Nexus type of thing. That would be pretty cool. And if not, then this whole thing is just kind of stupid. And then they just fed Jack Swagger to John Cena. Just, you know, warm up for SummerSlam. Made Jack Swagger look like a complete jobber. Why not? He is a complete jobber at this point. Then they fed Alberto Del Rio to CM Punk. So now, anytime that Alberto Del Rio wants to challenge against CM Punk, he's not even going to look like a legit threat. And they could just feed any of these top mid-carders to these main eventers, and it's not going to matter because their entire show is a bunch of jobbers anyway. And there was a total of one thing to be excited about, and that was the CM Punk versus John Cena thing, which was just being shoved down our throats so much throughout the entire show. It was annoying. They're saying, oh, this is going to be the greatest championship match of all time, the greatest championship match of all time, really. They had some stupid promo, a 5-minute video package of the whole rivalry instead of dedicating that time to other people that might deserve it. But judging by the flow of the show, they wouldn't have known how to book anybody else on the show. So why not? So you know what this show accomplished? This show proved that there's one thing to be excited about in the WWE, CM Punk and John Cena. This just proved how lackluster their star power is on the show and how lackluster all their rivalries are on the show. And how little we should actually care about anything on the show. Now people could say, oh, you know, typical IWC Mark, complaining, criticizing and whatnot. No, I'm actually positive. Even if a show sucks, I will say, look at the positives of it. But there was no positive of the show. The whole show completely sucked. It had here are your highlights. Christian coming up, which I marked out for. Christian on the show. John Morrison, which I hate John Morrison, so you know the show sucked if I'm saying John Morrison was a highlight. And then we get the main event, the contract signing, which I thought was going to suck. It actually turned out to be okay. CM Punk actually really is the voice of the voiceless. So pretty much, this entire show was a waste. It was forgettable. The matches were boring. The storylines were boring. This built no hype towards SummerSlam. There was just nothing good about this show. You know, this sucks. Like, SummerSlam is this Sunday and this is their freaking go-home show. And so I guess why I'm mad is, one, the Bellas weren't on the show, and two, I paid money for SummerSlam and I'm going to SummerSlam and I'm not going to like the show that they're going to put on. But hey, I should have a fun time there anyway. Fan access, and I should have fun cussing at Kelly Kelly during her match, which should be freaking awesome. I can see if I can get a We Want Melina chant started, since it is going to be in her hometown, so we'll see if I can do that. Anyway, yeah, that's pretty much it. The show doesn't deserve a sign-off, so whatever.